During last weekend, I had a chance to borrow a DJI Spark for test and review. This review will be up soon on the channel. And funny enough, one of the things that I really liked about the DJI Spark was the Quickshot modes. And now with the latest firmware 1.4, DJI has made it available for us Mavic Pro owners to use Quickshot modes. Welcome to Drones and Electric Unicycles, a channel where we make tutorial tips and reviews to help you get the best out of your drones and e-wheels. If you're new around here, then consider subscribing so you don't miss out on news like this. The idea behind Quickshots is to make videos with a duration of 10 seconds with rather complex camera movements. I've previously made tutorials that show you how you can make amazing footage by combining intelligent flight mode with stick commands. These tips made it easier to get those amazing shots, but it still required some practice to get it right. With Quickshot, it's made even easier. You just need to frame your subject and Mavic would automatically take care of the complicated part. Once the Quickshot has been completed, the Mavic will return and you're left with 10 seconds of great looking footage. This almost sounds too good to be true. There are three modes available for Mavic Pro Quickshot. It's Dronie, it's Helix, and it's Rocket. Before we look at some test footage, let me ask you a question. What do you think about 10 seconds predefined intelligent flight modes? What other flight modes would you like to see with the Mavic Pro? Leave a comment below. Don't be shy, as often the best advice is found among the comments from you guys in the Drones and Electric Unicycles community. Quickshot is only available after takeoff. The way it works, you go into the intelligent flight mode menu and then you select Quickshot. After that, you frame your subject with the green square that we know from some of the other flight modes on Mavic Pro. Then you select the Quickshot mode that you want to use and then press OK. Let's see the modes in action. Dronie, the aircraft will fly backward and upward and the camera will constantly be tracking the subject. Make sure there are no obstacles behind your Mavic when it flies back, as there's no sensors to save you from collision. Tap the Dronie icon to check and set the flying distance before you press go. Helix, the aircraft will fly backward and circling up around the subject. Tap the Helix icon to check the flying distance and set the direction before you press go. Again, make sure there's no obstacles on the side of your Mavic, as there's no sensors on the side that will save you from collision. Rocket, the aircraft will ascend with the camera pointing downward at the subject. Again, you can tap the rocket icon to check and set the flying distance before you press go. That's pretty cool, don't you think? The Quickshot modes are known from Spark, and actually the Spark has a fourth option called Circle. But this one is more or less identical to the one that we know called Point of Interest. And I guess this is the reason why DJI left it out. To access Quickshot, you need the latest firmware from DJI. This one is called 0104000, and you also need the latest version 4.1.10 of the DJI 4 Go app. And that is for both Android and iOS. It sometimes gets pretty annoying with all these updates from DJI. It seems it's pretty frequent at the moment, and sometimes you spend a lot of time updating your firmware before you actually can go out and fly. But once in a while, they really add value to the platform, like in this case with Quickshots. I think DJI is doing a fantastic job improving the Mavic Pro platform to the benefit of all of us. If you like this video about Mavic Pro Quickshot, make sure to smack that like button below, because this helps me understand if this is the kind of content that you like. Have a nice day and see you on the next one.